this fall. Karlos Baca, an indigenous food activist known for cooking beautiful foraged meals using traditional Native American ingredients and cooking methods, was approached by a regional food magazine. Would he like to provide a recipe for their Thanksgiving issue? Instead of getting a recipe from me, they got 3 pages of activism, he says. Baca, along with some other Native Americans who see the holiday as whitewashing the harm colonists did to indigenous people, refers to it as Takesgiving or Hatesgiving. Quote, typically, he won't participate in the dinner. I have a tradition of fasting, he says. But this year, Baca, who is Diné, Tewa, Nuche and lives in southwest Colorado, will be serving a 7-course meal in New York. The event was planned by the I Collective, a group of Native herbalists, seed keepers and chefs, though he rejects that last label. A chef is a French-European concept that I'm not even interested in anymore, he says. It follows on the heels of a 6-course October dinner at the James Beard House by Oglala Lakota Chef Sean Sherman, who is known as the Sioux Chef, a homophone to another French culinary concept, the kitchen's second-in-command job. The Sioux Chef, Native American chefs, whose foodways the culinary establishment has long neglected, have lately found themselves in high demand by a food media hungry to churn out trend pieces and by food-savvy urbanites eager to try cuisines they view as exotic. Quote, first it was Filipino food, then Hawaiian, then Jamaican. Now, recent coverage in food publications is calling Native American food the next big thing. And that's precisely the problem. This is not a trend, says Sherman. It's a way of life. Quote, thinking of Native American food as a trend perpetuates a number of misguided notions. First, that Native American food is a monolithic thing. The food HR countries indigenous people, some, like Baca, do not like the term Native American, because his ancestors predate the naming of America, is as diverse as the country's 567 federally recognized Native American nations. Outsiders tend to think of them in the aggregate, noting fry bread, a fry dough with various toppings, as one food that many share. Around Thanksgiving, one of the few times that schools teach students about Native Americans, many include fry bread as part of the curriculum. But Baca, Sherman and other chefs reject fry bread, which they see as a symbol of resilience under colonial oppression. The fried dough recipe, Sherman writes in his recently released cookbook, The Sioux Chef's Indigenous Kitchen, is the product of the government commodities that Native Americans were given during their forced migration, which separated tribes from their traditional foods. Baca and Sherman are among the Native American chefs who serve decolonized meals prepared with no pork, beef, dairy, processed cane sugar or wheat flour, ingredients that Europeans introduced into Native diets. Avoiding these ingredients is also healthier. They say, the colonists purposely destroyed food systems, first as a means of control, and the aftermath of it is horrendous, says Sherman, noting that Native Americans have an average life expectancy 4 years shorter than all other races and ethnicities in America. According to the Indian Health Service, they also die at higher rates than other Americans of such ailments as liver disease and diabetes. But because of the chef's focus on health, the Native food sovereignty movement has been conflated with faddish diets. Native foods are seen as superfoods, or they're likened to the paleo diet, whose adherents eat only things our Paleolithic ancestors could have eaten. Native American diets have been here for a long time, whereas the paleo diet was designed as a food trend, says Sherman, scoffing at the idea of Captain Caveman's diet, quote, and reducing a deeply spiritual food culture to its trend potential or its nutritive value is another example of a phenomenon called Columbusing, the practice among white people of acting as if something created by people of color didn't exist until they took note of it. like the intrepid explorer who discovered America, where indigenous people had been living for centuries. This happens frequently to food that becomes suddenly trendy. Faux collard greens and matcha have all been Columbus'd in the past year.